I wish you could have had a father like mine. Funny, tough, loving, generous, and honorable. My father knows how to have a good time, and he knows when it's time to be serious. I wish everyone had a father like mine. Don't you imagine Jesus thought the same thing? In John chapter 20, after John and Peter go back home after having seen the empty tomb, at the very least confused about what they have seen, Mary Magdalene stays behind. She's still weeping, and she peeks into the tomb to see it for herself again. But this time, she sees something she wasn't expecting to see. She saw two radiant angels, and then she sees the resurrected Jesus and has a conversation with him. Notice the exchange. John chapter 20, verses 17 and 18. Jesus said to her, "Do not cling to me, for I have not yet ascended to the Father. But go to my brothers and say to them, I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." God now relates to them in the same way he relates to Jesus. They relate to God as adopted sons and daughters. Their status is secured. Jesus refers to God as Father over 100 times in this gospel. 27 of those times he says that God is my Father. But here, and only here in the Gospel of John, he says, your Father. It's also the only time Jesus refers to the disciples as brothers. What this means is that the inheritance of Christ is our inheritance. The love that God the Father has for his Son is now ours. The security that the Son has is ours. And that makes walking with Jesus day by day all the more enjoyable. Everyone can have a father like Jesus' father because that relationship is available to all who will put their hope in Jesus Christ. As you pray today, please remember Joe and Myra Costa, our missionaries in Lebanon. And also remember the Cura LifeWord broadcast heard in Tanzania.